بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. The nasal flu vaccine has been used for several years for children specifically to protect against influenza or what is more commonly known as flu. Influenza is a very common and highly infectious disease caused by a virus. It is much more severe than the common cold, and for some people, such as those who are vulnerable, it could lead to serious health complications or even death. Now, the flu vaccine for children is a nasal spray sprayed into the nose and not an injection into the body. The live influenza vaccine contains live forms of flu virus which have been weakened. Now, these stimulate the immune system but do not cause disease in healthy people. Last year in the UK, over 3 million doses were given to children. And in the United Kingdom, the brand name of the nasal flu vaccine is Fluens Tetra. And in the US, it's known as Flumist. Many Muslim parents have been inquiring whether it is permissible to give this nasal vaccine to their children. This is because part of the ingredients of the vaccine is gelatine from pork. Now, the gelatine serves as a stabilizer that is highly processed and divided into smaller fragments in the vaccine. Due to the presence of pork gelatine, many have understandably raised the concern on whether we can use it as Muslims or not. Well, in terms of Islamic Sharia rulings, and according to many scholars from the Shia Ja'fari Ithna Ashari school of thought, such as Ayatollah Sistani Hafidhahullah, the permissibility depends on whether gelatin in this vaccine goes through a process of transformation, istihala, during the manufacture of the vaccine. Now, this would mean that the gelatin transforms to a completely new entity after production. If this can be ascertained, then it is permissible to use the nasal vaccine. Therefore, we have to search and find out. You're probably now asking, well, does it go through transformation? Personally, I've consulted my teacher Ayatollah Sayyid Fadhil Milani on this, and he confirmed to me that indeed it does categorically go through istihala, transformation. He also mentioned that the requirement for transformation is generally for anything that would be ingested, i.e. through the mouth, and not for a spray that is placed through the nose. Therefore, since this is a nasal spray, he confirmed that it is indeed permissible to use the nasal flu spray vaccine. If you have any questions on this, please visit the Ask the Sheikh section in our website, islamiced.org.